Harper Audio presents Flat Stanley's Worldwide Adventures, Book Number 8, The Australian Boomerang Bonanza, created by Jeff Brown, written by Josh Greenhut, performed by Vinnie Penna. Chapter 1, The Grand Prize. Snow whipped through the air in thick blankets. Stanley Lambchop trudged on, trying not to flap in the wind. Up ahead, Stanley could just make out his younger brother, Arthur.
"Keep going!" Arthur's voice called. "We're almost there!"
Since the morning Stanley Lambchop had awakened to discover that he had been flattened by the bulletin board over his bed, he had traveled far and wide. He had trekked through the Mexican jungle. He had crossed the African savannah. He had braved the Canadian Arctic. But this just might be his most difficult journey of all.
"And it's only the walk home from school," thought Stanley.
He strained to take another step, but the wind blew him off his feet yet again. He flew backward into the side of a bus shelter with a slap. Stanley groaned. Since being flattened, Stanley could do all sorts of useful things. He could travel by mail, slide under doors, and fly like a kite. But being half an inch thick also had its disadvantages.
"It sure doesn't help one bit in a blizzard," Stanley thought.
Arthur ran up.
"Are you okay?"
he cried over the howling wind. Stanley gritted his chattering teeth.
"I hate this weather."
Arthur nodded and held out his hand.
"Hold on to me!"
Stanley couldn't grab his brother's outstretched mitten, so Arthur leaned into the wind and battled down the sidewalk, dragging Stanley's body flapping behind him like a cape.
"I wish we lived somewhere hot," Stanley grumbled. "Tell me about it,"
Arthur called over his shoulder.
"Can you believe that right now it's summer in Australia?" "We could be on a beach," said Stanley. "If only I'd won that kangaroos contest," said Arthur.
Kangaroos was Arthur and Stanley's favorite breakfast cereal. Several months ago, Arthur had cut out a form from the back of their cereal box and entered a contest whose grand prize was a trip to Australia. Nothing ever happened, though. Arthur pulled Stanley up the front steps of their home. Pushing the door closed behind them, Stanley flattened himself against it and took a deep breath. A row of icicles fell from the side of his body.
"Thank you, Arthur," he said. "I don't know how I would have made it without you."
Arthur shrugged.
"I don't know how you make it anywhere without me."
He pulled off his boots.
"After all, who was it that saved you on Mount Rushmore? Who solved all your problems over the telephone when you were in China? Who got us down the river in Africa?" "You're the one who dropped the paddle," cried Stanley,
suddenly thawed under the collar.
"I did not," replied Arthur. "You dropped the paddle." "I did not,"
huffed Stanley.
"Arthur, is that you?"
Their mother's voice called from the next room. Arthur held up his hands.
"I'm just saying,"
he said in a low voice.
"The next time you go somewhere, take me along, will you?"
Then he added,
"Especially if it's Hawaii or Florida."
Stanley couldn't help it. He smiled.
"You're here!"
Mrs. Lambchop came bustling down the hall, her eyes fixed on Arthur. She seemed very excited.
"Wait until you..."
The smile fell from her face.
"Why, you look like a wet dog."
Arthur scoffed.
"I just walked through a blizzard."
Their father, George Lambchop, appeared with a comb and started dragging it roughly through Arthur's hair.
"Dad!"
protested Arthur. Mrs. Lambchop bit her lip.
"And his socks are all wet."
Their parents didn't even seem to notice that Stanley's socks were wet, too.
"What is going on?"
Arthur and Stanley both cried.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.